Okay, so in this video, we connect to a remote GNS3 server. I have started my VPN, and that is connected. And so now I'm going to connect to GNS3 to a remote server. And I'm going to actually set up a topology. And we're going to create a new project here. We'll call this one MM-Tek. And we're going to do OK on that. And now what I want to do is actually change this so it says installed appliances instead of available appliances. And these are the devices that we have already set up on this server instance of GNS3. And we're going to use the IOSB routers. We're going to go to configure, and we're going to go to network. And so what I want to do here is go ahead and look at the topology that I'm going to be using. So we're going to be using the mesh topology. And this is the topology that we want to use here. Move this up so we can actually see the IP addresses on it here. And if you look at this, Switzerland here is sort of the core of this network. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is going to need 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 connections out. And that's going to be, this going to be the router that has the most number of connections here. So let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now I have 7 connections on this. I can duplicate this device. And when I do, the number of connections that it has will duplicate as well. So we'll keep duplicating this one here. So we have the record quality really quickly. We have a total of 7 routers here in our core. Let's verify that this looks enough like our topology. That does something like this. Maybe we should line these up. And then we need to connect between them. So I'm going to go over here and we'll do from 1. Now, one of the things that I'm going to need to do here. I'm going to need to make sure this goes on my diagram as far as which things are where. So I'll need to go back in and modify my diagram. This here. I'm going to rename these routers so that they don't have these long names on them as well. So I'll be changing that in a couple of minutes to match our topology here. And I probably won't put edge on these. So if I go here, I go to configure, then I will call this one Switzerland. I think this one is India. Europe. Germany is part of Europe. They have a separate router in Germany. Okay, so this is our core. And show interface labels. Kind of have to fix this up here. I think this is the order we need to go in. I'm not totally sure on that. Okay, now let's look back at our topology and we'll see what else we have going on here. Now, one of the things you'll probably notice is these are all serial connections and GNS3 doesn't bother with layer 2, and so those don't really show up the way you expect them to. So now we have a series of ASAs that are going out off of each one of these routers. And let's see if we can do any configuration on these. So I'm going to actually drop these down to okay, so we can go ahead and duplicate these as well. And so there needs to be one for each of these networks. Okay, so we did all those from 00 to 00. And one of the things we're going to have to do here is reduce this down in size just a little bit so we can make this a little bit prettier here. Okay, so I feel moderately okay about this. And then inside of each of these devices, we're going to actually do another internal router. This is going to be a router on the stick. We don't need as many interfaces on this. Let's pull a new one over. Go to configure on it, and it has 4 adapters, and I think that should be enough. Duplicate each of these. Thank you. going to need to have a Cisco layer 2 switch here. Let's see, in terms of network 16 adapters. So those turn out to be like 4 and 4, 4 segments of 4. That'd be fun. Should be for what we're doing here. That could be okay. I figured it out a bit later. So I'm gonna switch in with routers. Then let's connect from the ASA. So now we have, we still have a couple more here. Let's get these. And there's nothing specific about the interfaces we're connecting them to. It's just something to make it consistent. Now, if you look at the topology, we'll have a Linux web server sitting off of each of these devices. For right now, just to simulate that, I'm going to put virtual PCs out for those two, and then we'll go ahead and change those over. And we probably won't change all of those, we'll just change selected ones over so that the server that we're running on. And I'll be replacing some of these virtual PCs that are inside of these networks with actual Windows 10 machines as well. But again, I try to not overtax our server any more than we have to. Okay, so this should be all of our devices in here. I'm them here just so that you can see you can connect to them. But honestly, I won't leave them in these ports because when I start configuring my VLANs, I want to make sure that's a little bit easier to do. Start all of these nodes here and see what this does to my total RAM usage. Pretty good, nothing except it keeps going up. Okay, so now we have all of our devices on the network. We're probably going to add in another machine connected off of one of these locations just to do something like Kali Linux with. But we're not going to do that just yet. And so we're using 67.8% of the RAM that's allocated to this single virtual machine. Okay, so that is setting up for our MM-Tek topology. We'll come back with a actually configuring the core next.